Hey, welcome back to the CCIE lab. In this video, I'll show you the details about Data Center 2. And as you see over here, and that it's a basic data center. There is no redundancy in the components inside. So we have one switch, which is representing the layer 2 connectivity switch with the ISP. And then we do have one firewall, and then we have one core switch. Inside core switch, we have two VRFs. Sorry, one for the borderless security and one for files DNA, as you see over here. Let's check the configuration for this switch. And you can see we have three VLANs, each for one VRF. And then we do have two interfaces, which with all the VLANs, E00 and E01, which is E00 facing the ISP, and A01, which is facing to the firewall. And then we have two E02 and E03, which is basically show run interface E02. That's with the VLAN 10. And the other one would be LAN 11. So this is the way that the connectivity of which then we go to the ASA firewall, show interface IP brief, and then we can see the external IP address for the sorry. For the public IP address, and then we have the let me see which one is which. I don't remember. Okay, so E01 is for files DNA, and E02, which is for borderless security, and then we have the internal interfaces for borderless security and files DNA as in from this side. Let's check the BGP route, and then you can see over here we have the public IP address that we're receiving from dot 2, which is R18 over here, and then the rest of all the BGP routes. This is, as you remember, the loopback interface of R27, which is representing the NTP and the DNS, and the rest of all the services. Then we go to switch 36, and let's see what's inside that one. Show run the VRF. So we see here two VRFs, one for borderless security and one for files DNA. And for borderless security, we're using 50136. Then we have the VLAN 101, and then we have the OSPF4 belong to that one. So each VRF has its own VRF. So as you see over here, files DNA using OSPF1, and borderless security using OSPF2. So if we show run section OSPF, you can see over here we have two OSPF instances running for each VRF. Okay, let's check on the HSRP what we have here. So standby brief. We don't have HSRP because basically it's only one core switch, so there is no need for that. But let's say what interfaces we do have. We have VLAN 10, we have VLAN 11, which is going to the firewall. VLAN 10 is for VRF files DNA, and VLAN 11, which for borderless security. Then we have VLAN 101 and 110, which is representing the interfaces that belong to each VRF. So files DNA have VLAN 110, and borderless security have VLAN 101. Okay, let's check out what's inside the Docker file for files DNA. We go to system and then meet fconfig, and then let's check what is the IP address. So he's using 192.168.110.100, as you see over here, 192.168.110.100. So this is good. That's mean files DNA here can or should be able to communicate with a data center, borderless security, and also with files DNA headquarter or the branch. So since we are into we are here files DNA, so we should be able to communicate with files DNA headquarters. Let's check that. So ping 10.20, I believe, dot 50.100. Okay, that's good. So we are able to ping this IP address over here. Let's try with dot 60. So 60.100, and that's the same thing. So we are able to communicate from headquarters and files DNA to the data center. Same thing, we should be able to communicate between data center and data center. So this guy, he should be able to ping this guy. So ping 192.168.10.100 over here, yes. So which is the Docker 61, so that's good. And also we should be able to ping .20.10, which is the Windows server. Yes, that's correct. So this is all looks good for the data center two in terms of files DNA. Let's check on borderless security, and we do have over here also a Docker file. Let's check what we can ping fconfig, let's check the IP address first, which is 172.16.101.100. So basically this is the VLAN 101 and it's 100. So borderless security, we should be able to ping borderless security over here in data center. Let's double check. So ping 172.16.0.100. So this is pingable, that's good. And then we need to ping now the headquarter over here for the borderless security. So that will be ping 10.30.70.100. So this is also pingable. And then we go to the other one, which is 80. So that's also pingable. So that's very good. We have all the connectivity between data center two and data center one, and then we have it with the headquarters. So that's it for the data center two. Let's move on to the last part of the lab, which is borderless security branch one. Thank you.